Hi, I'm Susan Arruda. Thank you for joining me on this seated posture segment. You know, if you have a job that requires you to sit all day, you are definitely going to want to put these exercises, these stretches into practice so that you can save your back and keep your posture in proper alignment. Okay, so now, sitting is now known as the new smoking. So if you do prolonged sitting for too many hours in your day, it can wreak havoc on your health, especially on your lower back. It can cause tight muscles. It can cause tension headaches if you don't assume a good posture. So I'm gonna take you through some exercises to help you. So first things first, you've gotta have proper alignment. So a good practice is to actually have a mirror right by your side so you can properly monitor what you're doing. You will not naturally know if you're doing it properly unless you have a visual to help guide you, of course. A mirror is an amazing tool. Use it. Use it as a tool to help with your alignment. Okay, so now sitting at this chair, I like to sit at the edge of my chair just because I'm accustomed to keeping good posture. I've trained myself, and if you're not yet there, of course, it can become your new natural and your default. It just takes time to get there, so you need to put this stuff into practice. So angles are important. So you want to be anatomically correct with your angles. If you are fortunate enough to have a desk that lowers and lifts and has the ability to adjust, that is amazing because standing desks are now becoming more popular for the reason of, you know, trying to not stay in that seated posture all day. Okay, so first things first, you want to bring the back of your chair really close to you. You want to have proper alignment, proper angles, 90 degree angle. So if you need to raise, put your feet under a platform to raise them to make that happen, do it. If you can adjust the height of your desk, you are very blessed. So make it happen. If you need to put something under your computer, whatever it is, make your workspace anatomically correct for you. Okay, so here, you're gonna push your shoulders down and back, okay? So let's exaggerate this. You're gonna lift your chest up, okay? Now, don't let your chin jut forward, pull it back. Ears in line with the shoulders, shoulders in line with the hips, okay? You want to monitor your alignment, have a mirror at your side so you can frequently do a posture check. And you're gonna imagine that you have a pencil in your upper back here in your rhomboids, and you're squeezing it together, okay? Squeeze it together and keep everything in alignment and breathe. So you're pulling the navel into the spine in that drawing that I discuss in detail in my Seriously Sexy Abs video workout program. You want to master this, okay? Flat back, and this is it. So now pushing your shoulders, you can do some shrugs, shoulder shrugs. Backwards is more of what we need because in a seated position, your shoulders want to run forward, so just counter that that position, okay? So when you are sitting here, a good practice when you're especially just learning is to put a book on your head or around here. I use a flutter board, and I actually do drills in the water with a flutter board on my head, which really is the telltale of, are you keeping your posture correctly? So you're gonna sit up nice and tall, practice that, and do what you need to do while on your computer, okay? Now, again, even though I'm leaning forward slightly, okay, I do not want my upper back to round and collapse, okay? So, down and back, and pulling in tight, and working away. Now, of course, at first, when you first attempt to do these, they're going to feel really strange, really odd, because it's not your natural, okay? I promise you, if you keep this up for several weeks, it will just, your body will assume this default position, and you're going to catch yourself doing the wrong thing when you kind of collapse or get fatigued and tired. When you get fatigued and tired and you lose your posture, that's a sign you need to take a break, okay? So ideally, you want to take breaks every 30 minutes, every 60 minutes, no longer than 60 minutes in that static position, okay? Have a water bottle always beside you at your workstation so that you're hydrating properly, and that will also take care of you having to get up and move and go for a walk, okay? So I'm here, so I'm feeling like my body is starting to get tight and achy, so quite simply, you're gonna stand up, sit down, okay? Put your weight through your heels. I always cue, lift your toes up slightly in your shoes, and think, sit down, straight up, okay? You wanna do this without leaning forward, so keep that visual cue of the pencil in your upper back. Exhale as you lift, keeping the abs in tight, and that's a squat, quite simply, okay? Now, when you're sitting, ideally you want to push back against your chair, but as you get better and you're able to assume this position, you want to kind of put that into practice. You're getting an ab workout doing this as well. So you're pulling it through the abs, your abs are working. Typically when you lose your posture, you're losing that drawing, losing that ab contraction, and the stress goes onto your lower back. Not good, okay? So now another option is one-legged pistol squat, okay? So I've got assistance here, so this is great practice to get better at this, okay? And then putting your hands behind your head, opens up your chest, press your elbows back, okay? So those are just some good ones. I love the figure four stretch. I'm tight in the glute medius, iliotibial band, IT band, usually a tight spot for many. So I'm just gonna sit up nice and tall, push, apply pressure with this top leg against my stabilizing leg, okay? And right here, this is on the stretch already. Now to magnify, intensify the stretch, you wanna lean forward without allowing this to happen, okay? If you already have rounding in your shoulders and upper back, you really wanna counter that by keeping the shoulders pressed back, okay? Retract and push down, and also you can kind of grab the sides of your chair as you do that, and of course switch off and keep it in balance. You're gonna find one side is typically tighter than the other. Another way to do this is, let's get into this position. I'm gonna push gently, lean forward, just casually pressing down gently. You don't want to feel joint stress. You want to feel the tension on the muscle, okay? Good pain, not bad pain. Good stretching pain, all right? It's just it should feel good, okay? All right, now in this position, I'm gonna reach back. And this also helps me to retract and push my shoulders back. Don't let your abs fall forward, which is what, you know, your body naturally wants to do. Okay, another really good upper body stretch, which we need many of when we're sitting, is this stretch, okay? Now, just pushing down and breathing through that, okay? Streamline position. Just squeezing the sides of your head with your upper arms, and you know, while you're reading, you can do all this tricep stretch, rotate through the wrist, okay? And of course, you wanna lift up nice and tall, stay tall. Here's another shoulder stretch, tricep stretch, shoulders, push across, and press that shoulder down. You wanna wiggle through the fingers, rotate through the wrist, especially if you have carpal tunnel. And of course, if you're doing a lot of typing, that is calming. So hopefully you wanna always offset and get circulation moving and keep yourself on stretch. All right, now for simply just toe tapping, you're working your shins. Okay, you do that enough throughout your day, you're gonna have solid, strong shins. Okay, now also just pulling up through the toes, heels down, toes up, maintaining proper alignment. That stretches your calves and just keeps you moving, okay? So now, again, just up and down. If you just cross your legs in this seated position, okay, and pull up, pull your shoulders down and back, abs in, and pull that knee in. Of course, you can do that straight on and across the body, okay? And in this position, you can lean forward. So all kinds of options there. Another thing I like to do is if you have, you can just lean forward against the desk and just press down gently towards the desk. Maintain a flat back. It's always a nice stretch for the upper body. And don't forget torso twists. You're gonna just keep your shoulders square, rotate, and grab the side of your body or the chair. Maintain correct posture if you've got that board on your head, that book, that helps. Pushing down. Don't let that chin jut forward. The other side. And of course you can just do it and reach across. This brings the shoulder on stretch as well. Just really do what works for you in the area that you're at, just stretching back. Now, another good way to get circulation going is you're gonna do tricep dips. These are great. Just don't fall. If you have a sliding chair, that'd be so good. And of course, you're gonna do this with one leg held up, switching off. Now, just bringing the knees up and down like a walking tight movement, knees up to the chest. Again, maintaining, watch your alignment, use that mirror. You got a good mirror. Okay, and pulling up. Abs stay in this tight. And fidgeting is good. It helps blood continue to move around. And, you know, if there's no one around, do it to your heart's content. You may want to be quiet with your fidgeting if you're around a lot of other people. It can annoy some people. What can you do? Set the trend. Another thing is lift your legs up. If you're prone to swelling in the legs, you're going to want to have a platform, maybe under the desk, under the table. A stability ball works really well. So things like that. Come up with your own stretches. Okay. Another good one is because we can carry a lot of tension in the neck, is you want to hold and assume that posture, look to the right, look to the left, right, and look slightly behind you, and then you want to press those shoulders down and drop your ear to your shoulder. You're going to just pull gently and allow this area to stretch. This can manifest itself as really bad headaches, so keep moving, keep stretching. Massage, of course, is a wonderful thing to keep all those knots out of your shoulders and neck area. Foam roller, and just keep things moving. Listen to your body when you're starting to get, starting to feel a little bit anxious. The more you do this, the more your body's going to remind you to do this. Initially, when you start, set a timer, okay? And stick to it, and you're going to see amazing results. I want you to take notice of the alignment here, so you can see a little bit better without my black shirt on, how right angles are so important. So that's what you wanna be mindful of, okay? So shoulders, hips, knees over ankles, and ears over shoulders. Now, I'm gonna lift one leg up and just little leg lifts, working quads. Okay, do that with a single leg. You can do that with both legs at a time. Really challenging the core here as well when you're doing the two legs. And then stretch for the hip flexors, which is what's working, the quads and the hip flexors in that leg raise. You're just gonna kind of stretch, lie back in line with that quad. Keep the knee down, push gently against your hand, resist, and that quadricep, that thigh is on stretch, as well as the hip flexor. After working it, you wanna stretch it out. Okay, so now, when you do your torso twist, remember to twist and turn, shoulders square, and then you wanna be in your tallest position, okay? And keep your shoulders and scapular retraction, okay? Twist and turn, and also reach across for a more significant twist. More of a stretch, but again, listen to your body, and circles with your neck just to loosen things up. Another thing is when you do your squat, okay, your stand up, sit down, again, look at how your body is moving and stay upright. So I'm gonna demonstrate this now with flutter board, like I mentioned before. Flutter board is what I have on hand. You can use a book. So you want to balance first off, okay? So if I were to be working here, you know, this is just, I would work like this, but I would practice like this, okay? Now, it's not a bad idea to do that, because that'll really just emphasize you keeping correct alignment, okay? All right, so now here, kind of do the stand up, sit down, the squat, stand up, and sit down, okay? Drawing in through the abs, shoulders down, okay? As soon as that starts to shift, you know, I'm either going too fast or I'm not keeping alignment. So it helps if you look straight ahead in the distance, keep your weight through your heels, I'm lifting my toes up, and that is what you want to practice. Another thing is for this squat, you want to stop short of sitting down, okay? Up, and of course, to really get a workout in, you can just hold this isometric position for time, for 20 seconds, 15, 30, a minute, that'll really fire up the quads. Alright, so there you have it. Put those into practice, come up with your own, and keep doing these. They're going to become part of your routine, and again, just practice will help this make your posture so much better. It'll help alleviate pain, it will help prevent injury, prevent weaknesses, and gives your abs the chance to work throughout your day. All right, keep at it, don't give up, and this will become your new default posture position. It's gonna be awesome.